Okay, is everybody ready? I'm not ready. My fly was down. Now I'm ready. Okay, so in my last video, I mentioned that in my project settings in DaVinci Resolve 18, I set the timeline and output color space to Rec 709A instead of Rec 709 Gamma 2.4. And I just want to show you real quick why exactly, because I got a lot of questions about it. So, if you're on a Mac, in the project settings, if you set the timeline and output color space to Rec 709 Gamma 2.4, which is pretty much the standard for most video work, then your export might look like this when you open it in QuickTime. You see the difference here? This is what it looks like in Resolve, and this is QuickTime. It's way too dark. Now, the funny thing is, once uploaded to YouTube, it looks fine. Also in VLC player, for example, it looks fine. So it only looks too dark when you open it in QuickTime, and possibly some other Mac apps. And I've also heard some other creators say that they have the opposite problem, so that the colors look too washed out instead of too dark. But the cause of the problem is the same, it's the tags of the exported file. So DaVinci Resolve doesn't add the correct 709 tags when exporting the file, and then QuickTime doesn't recognize the file as a 709 file. So it looks like poop. Now, if it's only a QuickTime problem, then you could say, why even bother fixing it, right? Well, the thing is, a few months ago, I had to make a video for a client, and then they asked me to send them the file, the exported file. They didn't want a YouTube link. And of course, I got an email back saying, hey dude, it's too dark. What the heck are you doing? But that's probably because they opened the file in QuickTime. Now, of course, you could always ask first before you send the file, like, hey, are you gonna use QuickTime on a Mac to watch the video? And then you'll probably get a response like, I don't know, we're gonna use a computer? You know how it goes, right? So that's why for all my YouTube and social media work, online video, I just use Rec 709A. It looks great because Resolve will add the correct tags when exporting the file and everything will look consistent across all devices and platforms and apps. I came across an article about Rec 709A a few days ago and it said this. For internet-only deliveries or for users without a professionally calibrated monitor, this new setting, Rec 709A, provides an easy solution. And I'm working on a professionally calibrated monitor, but still, I think it's a nice workflow, and I don't have to worry whenever I send the file to someone I don't know, or I don't know what kind of computer they have. There are also other solutions, other options. You could also add everything manually, add the tags manually in the export window, but I think that using Rec 709 in the project settings for everything is the easiest solution. But can one of you maybe confirm that this is also true for Windows? So if a file is exported on a Mac in Rec 709A, does it look the same on a Windows computer, in Windows Media Player, or whatever they're using these days? Just to confirm it. It should, but I want to be 100% sure, and then I'll pin your comment at the top of the comments. I don't have a Windows computer, so I can't check it. Now, should you use Rec 709A for everything? Well, I don't know. I don't think so. Rec 709 Gamma 2.4 is probably still the best option for professional deliveries, you know, for TV and things like that. But like I said, for YouTube, online things, Rec 709A seems to work just fine. And I'm also not an expert, but shh, don't tell anyone, okay? Thank you so much for watching and see you in the next one.